This video is going to show you how to dimension your floor plan and some of the standards that we go by to make sure you know everything is nice and neat and you know very presentable. First thing we do when we're doing our dimension lines, and I'm just going to be moving the camera around a little bit here. First thing we do is we establish one side or the other, it doesn't matter, whichever is most comfortable for you. But what we do is we create some lines in front of the house or in front of whichever side that you're on. Now these lines are 1 foot from the face of the house. So I use my scale, quarter inch scale, and I measure 1 foot, 1 foot, and 1 foot. Okay, so basically with the zero here, 1 foot, 2 foot, 3 foot. And I just put little marks to mark each foot space. And then I use my parallel bar to draw the horizontal line all the way across. All right, now right here, you'll see there's a vertical line that extends from the corner of the house. And it's not touching the house. It's just like right above or right to the outside of that line. It doesn't touch. If you look at these closely, you see that they do not touch. But these are extension lines. This extends from the major points of geometry to show you where those major measuring points are. And as I go across the bottom of the drawing here, you'll see I have some more. This particular extension line marks the middle of this window over here. I'll zoom out a little bit. There's an extension line that marks the middle of this wall. One that marks the middle of the door, one that marks the middle of this wall, and one that marks the middle of this window, and then again we have the end of the building with another extension line. All right, so we have dimension lines, which are these that go across horizontally. We have the extension lines, which are the ones that extend from the geometry, showing you where you're measuring to on that piece of geometry. Now the horizontal lines, 45 degrees, I use my 45 degree triangle to just make those right there. Those are called termination points. You want to get those lines right where the extension line and the dimension line intersect. Okay, now those don't have to be there. That's just, some people use that, some people don't. It depends too on who you work for. The company you work for might require you to do that. Here in the class, you will be required to do that. So 45 degree termination lines or termination points right through the intersection of the dimension line and the extension line. And that just helps the person read where the measurements terminate. Now I'm going to measure, I'm going to show you how we measure this. Starting out here, first I want to point out my lettering. If you look at this lettering, it's all nice and neat. If you look closely, there are some faint lines above and below these words. Those are guidelines. They are 1/8 of an inch apart because I want my lettering to be 1/8 of an inch. My letters should be 1/8 of an inch tall. So I draw those guidelines at 1/8 of an inch apart, and then I write inside them. And as you see, I'm using all capital letters. So when you're drawing in architecture and you're notating on your drawings, you use all capital letters. And you'll see down here, I did the same thing on some of these other instructions. Now these are just instructions here. They're not something that you would put on your drawing. That's mainly for me to you. All right, so we drew our lines, and next thing we want to do, again, I want to establish that 1/8 of an inch space to draw my letters in. Okay, so my first measurement is going to be from here to here, which I take a good measurement using the quarter inch scale from termination point to termination point. And here I measure 11 feet, 6 inches. Okay, so 11 feet, 6 inches. The space that I'm going to put that lettering in, I'm going to start right here on the dimension line, and I just take a solid line from the ruler, and you know, you can use one of these graphing rulers, or you can just use a like a plain see-through ruler are always best to use, or you can just use a regular ruler, it doesn't matter. But what I'm going to do first is I'm going to measure 1/16 of an inch, which 1/16 of an inch on this ruler is measuring from the inch line to the first tick mark. That's 1/16 of an inch. So I'll just put a little mark there, a little light mark, to let me know that's where 1/16 of an inch is. And then I measure from that spot, I measure a whole 1/8 of an inch, which is going to be 2 tick marks. Okay. And then I'm going to mark that one. That's going to be the upper side, or the higher side of my letterings, using my parallel bar. And of course, you see I'm going to have some more dimensions down further as well. So I might go ahead and sort of mark those places as well. So I'm going to mark here for a dimension. Then I'm going to go down here and I'm going to put a dimension probably right here in the middle somewhere. There'll be one right here as well, and there'll be one right here. And of course, I know you didn't see that, but that's you get the point. All right, and now I go to the higher mark. And I go all the way across here and just kind of mark everywhere that I'm going to put a dimension, so I have some guidelines. Now, once I have my guidelines, you know, I can measure. This right here was 11 foot 6 inches, and you want to make sure that you're steady when you write. Now sometimes I use both my hands, and I'll do something like this or like this to keep my hand steady. You may not have to do that. As old people, you know, we sometimes have to put a little extra effort into being steady. But I'm going to draw 11 foot 6 inches. All right, then moving on, I want to measure from this point here, because this measurement here is from here to here. So my next one, I'm going to measure from here to there. This is going to be from the middle of the window to the middle of this door. Okay, so that is 10 foot 6 inches there. So real steady, 10 foot 6 inches. Okay, now as you notice, I'm writing my doing my lettering above the line. They're 1/16 inch above the dimension line. Yesterday I was going over this trying to get some people who were working ahead, and I told them to put their dimensions below the line. I was incorrect. They go above the line, but if you've already put them below the line, you don't have to go back and change them. But if you still have some dimensioning to do, put your dimensions above the line, and you'll remember that on any other future dimensioning assignments. All right, so basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue that throughout, and also, you know, labeling these lines. Now, you don't have to write this right here, but this line here, this first line, the one closest to the house, is for doors and windows. So I'm going to measure to the middle of each door and window, and of course measure to the very end from end to end. The second line is for major walls. Major walls are any walls that come in contact with the exterior wall. So that's a major wall, and this is a major wall. And of course there's other major walls around the house. So on this middle line would be measurements from the very end to the middle of the first major wall, from the middle of the first major wall to the middle of the next major wall is a measurement. Then from the middle, and of course I see you can't see that there, and then from the middle of that major wall here to the end, okay, all get dimensions. So to finish this line out here, I get 6 foot 6 inches on this one. And then here, I get 4 feet exactly. OK, Okay, so then I start, go back to this line and do my major walls. So from the end of the house to this first major wall is 20 feet and 6 inches. And of course I haven't drawn my guidelines in there yet, but I'll let you handle that from here. Make sure that you get all the measurements between these, and when you get them, add them up to make sure they equal your overall measurement. Your overall measurement is out here. My overall measurement is 32 feet 6 inches. So, and I've got some guidelines. Actually, I was supposed to draw it up here, but let's say 32 feet 6 inches. Now, what I want to do with that, knowing my overall dimension, I want to add these up to make sure that it all equals 32 feet 6 inches. And it's real simple. You do that by turning your inches into feet. Okay, I mean your feet into inches, sorry. Use your calculator, this on your phone. And, you know, of course, multiply, add 11, 10, 6, and 4 for feet. Add all those together and then multiply by 12 inches. And that'll give you a total 12 figure. And then you just add the other inches. You know, you got add 6 inches, 6 inches, 6 inches to that total. And you come up with total inches for your entire front span there. Now I can come by and show you what I mean by that if you're not understanding it. But what you after that, then you just calculate and make sure everything comes up even, that whatever this 32 feet 6 inches for the overall, that the measurements in here also add up to that. So that is dimensioning. And now, of course, after that, you have you'll want to go all the way around the house. Here you get three lines: doors, windows, major walls, and then overall. Over here on the other side, you get the same thing: doors, windows, major walls, and overall. Okay, again, making sure you put your dimensions above the dimension line, not below it. Now back here in the back, okay, now I don't put an overall dimension back here because I've already got it down here. So here all I'm going to put is a line for the major walls and a line for doors and windows. Same when I come over here. I've already got the overall dimension here. So here I just draw, and actually all I needed was one line here. I needed a line to mark just my major walls. Okay, so that's, I've got one line here. It kind of looks like there might be more than one, but that's, those are, some of those are guidelines. Okay, and again, remember 1/8 of an inch for the space for your letters and your numbers, 1/16 of an inch above the dimension line, and 1 foot apart. Now, of course, this one only had one line, but I put it at 2 feet out, so that whoever's looking at it will know that this is the major walls line. Okay, so I wouldn't measure just 1 foot out. That would say that it's doors and windows. But keep everything consistent. You know, measure out for this one. If it's just major walls that you're measuring, then, you know, extend out and a total of 4 feet instead of 2 feet. All right, any questions, just come and see me.